Hi, my name is Margret. In this video, I want to show you how you can create a runnable jar file that includes the Java code. Here, I created a simple GUI application that allows me to play the memory game. And I called my Java project assignment memory. So I'm going to select it, I right click, and I choose export. And when I export, I have different options here. I'm going to my Java option, and in my Java option I have either char file or runnable char file. Now there's a temptation to click the runnable char file here, but we are not going to do that. If I choose runnable char file, then I will no longer be able to specify that I need my source code included. So I have to go to my first option, char file. I click next. And because I selected assignment memory already, Eclipse remembers that this is the project I want to have included in my char file. It also assumes that I want to export the generated class files and resources. But in addition, I want to make sure to check this very checkbox here. It says export Java source files and resources. This checkbox allows me to specify that the Java source code needs to be included. Here, I can browse to a special place where I want to store my char file or give it a special name. In my case, I like to have it in ctemp and I want to have it named memory char. Notice how finish is already blue. There's a temptation to click on it, but we don't want to do that. If I click finish at this point, it's not going to be runnable. So I need to go to next because I need to make a change in the manifest. So I go to next, which allows me to specify some packaging options. We don't want to do that. So I keep going. Next, one more time. Now it says char manifest specification. That's where I can specify that my char file should be runnable. The way I do that is by letting my char file know where the main method is. Once the char file knows which class includes the main method, it can start the execution right there. So rather than just typing in a path, I can just go to my browse button and it gives me the different options of classes that include a main method. In my case, there's only one possibility. The only class that includes a main method is in GUI memory. So that's easy. That's of course the one I'm going to select. Here it gives me memory.GUIMemory and now I'm ready to say finish. At this point, I show you my folder. A file memory.char has been created. I'm going to run it now. I can just double click here and it opened on my second screen, so push it over. Here is my memory game and I can just click on the different images and play my memory game. Another way to run a runnable char file is in the console. So here I say Windows R to start my console. We're going to say OK. Open the window right here. We push it over. And I'm navigating to my temp folder. So we're going to temp. We are listing our files. It includes memory.char. And I can just say java-char memory.char. Once again, it opened on a different screen. And I can play my memory game again.